So, in very good news, we have zero community cases today. So, wonderful news. We only have one case detected in hotel quarantine. So, that's fantastic news. So, 47 active cases. We've had 5,835 tests in the past 24 hours. And we've had 3,776 vaccines by Queensland Health, but that's because it's a Sunday. So there's no cases in the community is excellent news, and we haven't had a case infectious in our community now since the 5th of July. And I want to thank everyone in Queensland, especially Southeast Queensland and Townsville, for doing the right thing. And because everything is going so well, I can advise that on the advice of Dr. Young, we can ease our restrictions from 6 a.m. Friday, July 16. So that means that the masks will be required still at airports and planes. No restrictions on hospitals and aged care. And I know how hard this has been for people with loved ones in aged care and hospitals. So that's fantastic news. Of course, to your home, if you're going to have over 100 people, you'll have to keep their details. Lots of good news for the young people out there. You can go dancing again. And of course, the pubs, clubs and cafes will be able to increase the numbers of their customers from 1 per 4 square metres to 3 per 4 square metres. So we just wanted to make sure that we were giving business this timely advice that they can prepare. But of course, we are going to be monitoring very closely about if there are any further cases of community transmission. But at this stage, fingers crossed, it's all looking terrific. So that's fantastic news. I also just wanted to talk about the borders. So what we've seen is some other states and territories putting in place a hard border closure. At this stage, Queensland is monitoring the situation in Greater Sydney and New South Wales very closely. So we've just had extensive discussions this morning, and we'll be having those extensive discussions each and every day. Our job, my job, is to keep you safe, and that is the forefront of our consideration. Dr. Young is very much closely monitoring all that sewage testing around the state of New South Wales. And at the moment, because that Greater Sydney is in lockdown, we are very comfortable with keeping that Greater Sydney area a hotspot. However, my message to Queenslanders is if you are in those areas, to come home. I can't be any clearer. Please, if you are in, you know, regional parts of New South Wales, we are monitoring that very closely, and things can change. So my message to Queenslanders is think seriously, long and hard about what you're doing, and if you can, come home. So we're monitoring very closely. We are not imposing any further restrictions at this stage, but I'm just giving everyone notice that we are monitoring this incredibly closely. And to the people...
Okay, that was Anastasia Palaszczuk there. Some good news in that there are no community cases in Queensland of COVID and restrictions easing from 6 a.m. Friday, but obviously foreshadowing potentially a border closure there with New South Wales asking Queenslanders to come home. We know that that can normally lead to that, even though she wasn't saying it, of course, but a pretty strong message there for Queenslanders.
Some foreshadowing there, as you said,
New South Wales.
Absolutely.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, Nat.